When you hear a show tune from the Great White Way, does a shiver run through ya? Well, we're giving them to ya. Sing hallelujah and shout hooray. Come on along and listen to Broadway to Main Street. You.
Well, that beautifully harmonized farewell to the Titanic only is our welcoming anthem here today on Broadway to Main Street. Hello, this is your host, Larry Maslon, here on Broadway to Main Street. 88.3 WLIW-FM, Long Island's only signature, one-of-a-kind, individual, harmonized NPR station. That, of course, is from Maury Yeston's Titanic. And although we are not sailing off into disaster, we are sailing off into 54 minutes of the greatest harmonized numbers among many, 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 many in Broadway history in honor of a show called, wait for it, Harmony, the Barry Manilow, a Bruce Sussman musical, which unfortunately is closing after the first week of February. I think it's a shame. I think it deserved a much longer time on Broadway. But we'll hear a little of that, and we'll hear a lot of other examples as well. Well, among Broadway composers who must take the devil's share, the lion's share of what it means to harmonize a piece of music would be George Gershwin. And he wrote a piece that is the opening of the second political musical, 1933, Let Him Eat Cake, that starts with two dueling presidential anthems just in time. But such a skillful piece of writing from Let Him Eat Cake. Here is George Gershwin and Ira Gershwin's Tweedledee for President.
wallpaper sticks to the wall.
Like the sea shark clings to the sea.
Like you'll never get rid of your shadow. Frank, you'll never get rid of me.
Let all the others fight and fuss. Whatever happens, we've got us.
We're closer than pages that stick in a
book.
We're closer than ripples that go in a brook.
Stone
wherever you find him, you'll find me just look. Closer than a miser or the bloodhound's Deliza me.
Closer than Smog is to all of L.A. Closer than Bobby is to JFK. None of our soul can bust this team in two. We stick together like glue. And when it's sleeping time,
that's when we ride. How do you like sitting in the back of the bus, Dean?
Our clocks don't chime.
What a surprise.
They ring. A ding ding. Happy New Year,
me. And now to repeat what we said at the start. They'll need a big crowbar to break us apart.
All alone, but far from blue.
Before we get Spanish, we'll make the town roar. We'll make all the late spots and then a few more.
We'll start in a Jilly's and maybe Toots Shaw.
Life is gonna be a wee wow wee.
Wee!
For my shadow
and me.
That, of course, was Frank and Sammy, Me and My Shadow, a song that's credited to, among others, Al Jolson, who didn't write a word of it, but he got a star credit. That's from 1927. He actually interpolated that into a show of his called Big Boy. And, you know, harmony isn't necessarily choruses full of people. It can be two or three or five or six individuals, and that's a very jovial one. Richard Rodgers, you know, second to none in composing talents. He and Larry Hart wrote a wonderful number from the Boys from Syracuse in 1938 that kind of, I wouldn't say spoofed, but tapped into the harmonizing sound of some of the grill groups at the time, the Boswell Sisters, probably anticipating the Andrew Sisters. So here is a wonderful number called Sing for Your Supper. Rebecca Luker and Sarah Uriarte Berry and Debbie Shapiro Gravit from the Encores performance. Take it away, ladies.
And you'll get dinner, dine with wine of choice. if romance is in your voice. I heard from wise canary trilling makes you willing. So little swallow, swallow now. Now is the time to sing for your supper, and you'll get breakfast. Songbirds are not dumb. They don't buy a crumb of bread, it's said. So sing and you'll be fed. Sing for your supper and you'll get breakfast. Songbirds always eat if the song is sweet to hear. Sing for your luncheon and you'll get dinner. Dine with wine of choice if romance is in your voice. I heard from a wise canary trilling makes a fellow willing. So little swallow, swallow now. Now is the time to sing for your supper and you'll get.
You're a rainbow I chase on a morning in spring. You're a star in the lace of a wild willow tree, in the green leafy lace of a wild willow tree. But tonight you're no star, nor a song that I sing. In my arms where you are sweeter than spring. Where you are, clinging closely to me, you are lovelier by far than I dreamed you could be. You are lovelier, my darling, than I dreamed.
Or a song that I sing. You're a rainbow I chase on a morning in spring. You're a star in the lace of a wild willow tree, in the green leafy lace of a wild willow tree.
But tonight you're no star, or a song that I sing. In my arms where you are sweeter.
Where you are, clinging close.
another Richard Rodgers spectacular, this time with lyrics by Oscar Hammerstein. That's from Allegro, and that's Patrick Wilson and the chorus. And the gimmick with Allegro from 1947, as many of you know, was the chorus was a kind of character commenting on the action or underlying certain verses of some of the solos, just like, wait for it, Greek tragedy. That was their kind of musical theater update of the how the chorus worked in Greek tragedy. And of course, Rodgers arranged it with his colleagues to a Fare Thee Well. Well, when you think of harmony in the Broadway musical, you're going to go maybe to barbershop quartets, great American tradition. And if you're going to go to a barbershop quartet, you are, of course, going to take a beeline on that train to the Music Man. Here is the cast of the current, of the recent revival, the 2022 revival of the Music Man, with Sutton Foster putting in a cameo appearance with Lida Rose.
Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, to get the sun back in the sky. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, about a thousand kisses shy. Ding dong ding, I can hear the chapel bell chime. Ding dong ding, at the least suggestion, I'll pop the question. Lida Rose, I'm home again, Rose, without a sweetheart to my name. Lida Rose, now everyone knows that I am hoping you're the same. Not fancy or fine, Lida Rose, oh, won't you be mine? Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose, oh, Lida Rose.
Dream of now, dream of then, dream of a love song.
Sweet old
listen. Do you hear what I
Well, if you were to ask me what is one of the most beautiful pieces of music in the American musical theater, it has to be that Song of a Summer Night, written by that Broadway mug, Frank Lesser, in one of his more lyrical and elegiac moments, again, for The Most Happy Fella. That's from a studio recording from England. So touching, so beautiful, so simple, and yet so complex, just the way we love it in the world of harmony. Peaceful, perfect peace and harmony, as Tevye might say. We come to the end of Act One of our show, and if you're going to do the end of Act One and you're going to do harmony, what else are you going to do but the close to Act One of Stephen Sondheim and James Lapine's Sunday in the Park with George? So take it away, Mandy Patinkin.
Dot, why did you write these words?
They are your words, George. The ones you muttered so often when you worked.
Order. Design. Tension. Composition. Balance. Light. Dot, I cannot read this word.
Harmony.
So much love in his words. Forever with his colors. How George looks. He can look forever. What does he see? His eyes, so dark and shiny. and dark.
And parasols.
People strolling through the trees.
Blank page or canvas, his favorite. So many possibilities.
And the curtain falls on Act One of Sunday in the Park with George. Well, not really, I guess, at this point. The scrim flies in, and you see Seurat's original painting superimposed on the cast. What a moment that was in the theater, folks. This is Larry Maslon, your host for Broadway to Main Street. And today, in honor of the musical Harmony, which is coming way before its time to a close, I urge you to go and see it. It's an important, interesting, compelling show. We're looking at harmonies. Here is our friend Andrew Lloyd Webber with a show I don't think he gets enough recognition for, Jeeves, or in America, By Jeeves. The gimmick here is you have a nice little quartet of harmonists, but the lead playing the banjo has his instrument broken. Well, it's a funny idea. It was funnier in 1975. I couldn't get that recording. Here is the revival of By Jeeves.
Banjo boy, play a number for me. Won't you play that melody? When you start your playing, mama starts a swaying. She's right there with her, stomping that rhythm. Banjo boy, play the razzmatazz. You're the sunny Southland's king. You said Dixie humming it when you started strumming it. See those fingers going.
What's that finger there?
When you start to syncopate, songbirds seem to orchestrate. The swan, he stops its blowing, just hear him play. Who can plunk your heartstrings full of joy? That's Banjo Boy.
On to C.
Hear him go.
F.
Don't you know?
G.
Love him so.
C.
Let him swing.
C again.
And do his thing.
F.
He's the king.
G.
Ding-a-ding.
Oh. Banjo boy, you're the musical sun in the southern sunny skies. Feet will stomp their fidgets, see those magic digits. Hands are a-clapping, fingers a-snapping. Banjo boy, play that favorite tune that the old folks love to sing.
Damn.
Can't you hear the children roar? Dixie shouting out for more. Hear the steamboat blowing. Eight to the bar. Who's that cotton picking hunk of joy?
Yes.
That golden kid that passion can't destroy.
It's me.
Who's Dixie shout from Maine to Illinois? That's Banjo Boy.
did we change? Caught in this strange new music set. Was I away too long?
Just like the tune, simple and clear, I've come to hear new music. Why can't you hear the song?
His fingers stroke those keys, and every note says please, and every chord says turn.
I knew what love was, but these lovers play new music, haunting me, and somehow taunting me. My love was never half as true, and I ask myself, why can't I sing it too? My life has changed. Sarah, you got to see. Sarah, we got a son. Sarah, come down to me.
Beautiful, beautiful arrangement of harmony, of course, from Ragtime. That's Mark Jacoby and Maren Mazey and co. from that show. Well, I said earlier that harmony doesn't necessarily require everybody in the cast to line up and break into four parts. And Susie, you take the top line and Jimmy, you take the bottom line, whatever that happens to be. It can be done very well among two people for dramatic reasons. I want to thank Sal Lerner for giving me this excellent example of such from Wicked.
I'm limited. Just look at me. I'm limited. And just look at you. You can do all I couldn't do. Linda, so now it's up to you, for both of us. Now it's up to you. Mm-hmm. people come into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most grow if we let them, and we help them in return. Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you. Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made of what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. And now whatever way our stories end, I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore.
How can they
hope seems so far. Look, look how they shine, these cruelest of stars. What promise inspires them? What faith is it fires them? Darkness grows, the world turns cold, and still there glows a light. Heaven knows what hope they tease these stars in the night. The darker the night becomes, the brighter their light becomes. Chill winds wail, the tempest brews, and clouds assail the sky.
That is Stars in the Night from Harmony, currently playing on Broadway. Run, run, run. Go and see it. That was suggested to me by our good friend Julie Benko, who's knocking them dead in Harmony, as well as she should. So we wish her and that cast a triumphant finish. Well, we're finishing up our show on Harmony. We have to say so long and farewell to listeners. So, of course, what else are we going to play but the following selection written by Rodgers and Hammerstein for The Sound of Music. Until next week, folks. So long, farewell.
But firmly they compel us to say goodbye.
my first champagne. No?
No.
Where is the time all gone to? This is Larry Maslon here at Broadway to Main Street. Let's catch up next Sunday at 3.
There's so much more embracing still to be done, but time is racing. Oh, well, we'll catch up some other time.